Hello and welcome back to Proactive. I'm delighted as ever to be joined on the line now by Jeremy Skillington, the CEO of Poolbeg Pharma. Jeremy, thank you very much for talking to us. And you've just released a clinical update on POLB001.
Yes, appreciate the time. Yes, we've just completed our LPS human challenge study with POLB001. And happy to report that there's no serious adverse events for this study. So again, very excited that we're making the progress that we are making. Again, hitting our timelines that we've mentioned earlier this year, etc. So yes, yeah, so we enrolled 36 healthy volunteers into this study, three different doses of POLB001. Challenge with LPS, which drives an immune inflammatory response. So we want to be sure and demonstrate that 001 blocks that inflammatory response. So again, safety readouts are good right now. Now we kind of dig into the deeper diving of the deeper data set, let's say, looking at the efficacy at the other end. So again, no further clinical activity required, which is a great milestone for the company. And delighted that we're on track and moving forward.
Lovely stuff. So you say it is a milestone. What does this step mean for progress on the asset?
Yeah, no, it's crucial. It's a pivotal part where we're demonstrating this human proof of concept, proof of mechanism when it comes to the use of POLB001 eventually for severe influenza. So this is kind of a step along the way to get us there. And, you know, I'd say we feel that this comprehensive data set, which is a challenge of both intradermal, just in the skin, as well as intravenous, which is systemic inflammatory response, will create a very attractive data set for pharma then to partner. And we may have, we've stated before, we've got intellectual property around the use of P38 inhibitors, which POLB001 is in severe influenza. So we're trying to meet that kind of, you know, medical unmet need that's there right now. And we've all seen the numbers that the flu is coming back with a vengeance post-COVID. So as I say, we're ready and we're ready and able to kind of develop a 001 for that indication.
Absolutely. Influenza seems to be at record levels this year. What does POLB001 mean for people suffering with flu?
Yeah, I mean, every year there's a scramble to identify what flu strain is emerging, and then they generate vaccines. And vaccines have a modest efficacy when it comes to influenza. They do have antiviral drugs that are only effective in the first 48 hours post-symptoms. So that's a very narrow window. So beyond that, there's nothing. And for those patients that, you know, progress into severe influenza, there's nothing there for them. And what drives the disease primarily is a cytokine storm. So our drug will block that cytokine storm, returning the patients back to normality very, very quickly. But you're right about the numbers. It's quite staggering. You know, during COVID and lockdowns, there was essentially, you know, zero influenza cases. But we've just learned it up to now. Since October, there's been 8.7 million illnesses reported. And it was 9 million all of last year. So there really is a surge going on right now that we're as I say, concerned about. But obviously, we're kind of on track to, obviously, this trial is finished, data analysis and partnering next year. And here's a drug that have potential role to play for severe influenza in the future.
Fantastic. Well, let us wish you the very best of luck, Jeremy. And thank you, as always, for coming to talk to us at Proactive.
I appreciate it. Thank you.